Welcome back. In this video, I will discuss how to apply k-means clustering algorithm to divide the given data set into different clusters. In the previous video, I have already discussed what is k-means clustering algorithm. Also, I have solved a few examples on k-means clustering algorithm. Link for those videos is given in the description below. In this case, we need to apply the k-means clustering algorithm and we need to divide the given data point into two groups. Here we have been given 6 data points. To calculate the distance between the data points and the centroid, we need to use Euclidean distance. Here the first two data points are considered as initial centroids. These are the 6 data points given to us, and these are the C1 and C2, these are the initial centroids. Now we need to calculate the distance from the data point to the initial centroid. We need to use a Euclidean distance. The Euclidean distance between the two data points x2, x1, y2, y1 is always equivalent to square root of x2 minus x1 bracket square plus y2 minus y1 bracket square. Now we will calculate the distance between the first data point and the first centroid, that is 185.72 and 185.72, is equivalent to square root of x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square, that is 185 minus 185 bracket square plus 72 minus 72 bracket square, which is equivalent to 0. Similarly, the distance between the second data point and the first initial centroid is 185 minus 170 bracket square plus 72 minus 56 bracket square, which is equivalent to 21.93. Similarly, we will calculate the distance from the remaining data points to the first centroid. They look something like this. Now we will calculate the distance from the data point to the second centroid, that is 170 and 56. The first data point is 185.72. By using the Euclidean formula, we can find the distance from the first data point to the second centroid is square root of 170 minus 185 square plus 56 minus 72 square, which is equivalent to 21.93. Similarly, we will calculate the distance from the remaining data points to the second centroid. Once we calculate the distance from the data points to the initial centroids, we need to assign the data points to one of the cluster based on the distances. The distance from the first data point to the first cluster is 0. The distance from the first data point to the second cluster is 21.93. Between these two values, 0 is the minimum value, hence the first data point is assigned to cluster as a C1. Similarly, the distance from the second data point is 21.93 and the second centroid is 0. In these two values, 0 is a minimum value, hence it is assigned to C2. Similarly, all the data points are assigned to either C1 or C2 based on the distances. Once we divided the data points into different clusters, next we need to find the new centroids. The new centroids are calculated by adding the data points divided by the number of data points in the cluster. The first cluster, we have 4 data points, that are 1st, 4th, 5th and 6th. Now we will add all these data points and we will divide by 4. In this case, that is 185 plus 179 plus 182 plus 188 divided by 4, which is equivalent to 183.5. Similarly, 72 plus 68 plus 72 plus 77 divided by 4, which is equivalent to 72.25. For the second cluster, 170 plus 168 divided by 2, which is equivalent to 169. 56 plus 6 divided by 2, which is equal to 58. Once we calculate the new centroids, we need to calculate the distance from the data points to the new centroids, and then we need to assign the data points to the one of the clusters. Again, we use Euclidean distance formula to calculate the distance from data points to the new centroids. The distances looks like this. Once you calculate the new distances, we need to assign the data points to one of the clusters. If you notice here, between 1.52 and 22.02, 1.52 is a minimum. So we will assign cluster as C1. Similarly, between the 21.13 and 2.83, in these two values, 2.83 is minimum. So we will assign cluster as a C2. Similarly, we will assign the remaining data points to one of the clusters. Now, if you notice, the previous cluster assignment and the new cluster assignment looks exactly same. The meaning of this one is that data point have converged. The first cluster contains the 4 data points. The second cluster contains the 2 data points, and the final centroids are 183.5, 72.25 and 169.58. This is how we can apply the k-means clustering algorithm on the given data set, and we can divide the data set into different clusters. I hope the concept of k-means clustering algorithm is clear. If you like the video, do like and share with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.